Hey guys, it's Ifter, and you might notice that we're back with more Nevermind. Well, over the holidays I managed to get a hold of, two devices that I need for the heart rate stuff to actually function. I'm using a Garmin Premium heart rate monitor soft strap with a little Amp Plus USB that lets it connect to the computer. And as you can see when I go here, it is working. So, Fear UI, let's leave that on, that might be helpful. Now, I don't know what this data set means. I assume it's collecting my general heart rate. I really hope that that's a normal heart rate. It seems to be going higher. But, data set. So, it says, connections are not instantaneous. The device itself must first initialize, and then Neurostalgia Systems must build a database based upon the data received from the device. So, basically, it's now got a database. Fear sensitivity, I'm gonna leave as default. I'm gonna leave the UI on, like I said. But other than that, and other than not actually having a clock anymore because my room is now completely different, I figured we'd go through the beginning again to see what changes. Now, if you remember the last time, the game was pretty simple considering I couldn't really make use of all of the Garmin stuff. Or all of the heart rate stuff, not specifically Garmin. And I'm not gonna really spend much time here. Last name. Last name. No. Let's see. Can't think of a last name. Let's think of something quick here. I go with my old name on YouTube. Sure, Ifter Hillshire, whatever. This time, I actually am wearing the thing. Now, I assume most of this is gonna be the same. Just to make sure that it's still counting the sensor. I was having a little bit of a problem getting it set up, and other than that, okay, everything's fine. But yeah, I was interested to see... I was interested to see how the heart rate monitor would actually change things. So I'm mostly going to try and rush through this beginning section so we can actually get to the good bits. It's like client. Alright, so... I could do these, I guess, already, it seems? Okay, so these bottom four will be made available in the future. Interesting. Alright, so I have to go through the tutorial again, which is fine. Now, something I have learned is that this game is not finished. They're attempting to get the money to finish the game, but I don't know how successful they've been up until now. Kind of unfortunate because, you know, it seems interesting enough. Alright. And they're going to explain to us the game again.
Things have become almost unbearable for me. And for my family. Nothing has helped. I guess that's what...
Now, considering you've already seen this stuff, he's having issues. Food makes him uncomfortable.
Welcome to NeuroProber Training. I am pleased to be your guide.
Yeah, I can right-click to skip stuff. Now, the Fear UI doesn't seem to be showing.
Whether you are speaking with the client directly, you'll find somehow.
So let me dive back in here just real quick. Still sensing it. Fear you, I wonder... I wonder if it's just because, unless it's that thing up at the top, I'm pointing at my screen like an
some parts of
holy like an idiot. I'm wondering if it's that thing up at the top left of the screen. It said there was a way to interact with these, right? Was it right-clicking and rotating? Yeah, right-clicking and rotating.
While neuropro- this t-
And again, mostly trying to skip through stuff you've already seen. That
the most important.
A lot of the information we're getting here again was, you know, be careful, collect the photos, its most important job is to piece things together. And we're inevitably going to try and fill things up on that board.
Interacting with one part.
So let's go ahead and enter in. Now, since it's a tutorial, I imagine they're going to save the scares, and here we go. Okay.
Have you noticed that the world can sometimes become fuzzy and degraded, like static on a television? That's the client's subconscious mind reacting to your own feelings of fear, stress, and anxiety. The subconscious doesn't take kindly to intruders and will take every opportunity to feed off of any sensations of anxiety or tension you offer to it. If you can, try to stay calm and peaceful, even in the face of terror. If you can calm yourself, you'll find the subconscious will calm itself too.
And as you can see, the fuzziness is new. That was not a feature of the game before. And I'm pretty sure that the heartbeat thing at the top left is increasing as my heart rate goes up, and is lowering as my heart rate decreases.
Here is an example of an especially buried memory. Some details of a given trauma can be especially tenacious. But by gently and cleverly listening to the clues the mind gives you, you will find all you need to work through it. Just think of it as a puzzle for you to solve. When you focus on these puzzles...
And this wasn't much of a big deal. It was mesh... match the rocks to the mouth of the bird. And we take the little birdie. No, it seems like so far the having your heart rate monitored isn't making a big deal, other than making the screen a bit fuzzy. But as she said, as I tend to calm down, the fuzz will start to go away, and I'm not really too anxious, so it's kind of unfortunate that, it seems so sensitive. Okay. The intro stuff probably not going to scare me too bad
while
since I've already seen it.
Your consciousness, while this is a journey, if you need to access any, this will bring up your...
As you said, I can pause at any time. Like, a lot of the stuff isn't new. We've seen it. Here. Unfortunately, we don't have enough pictures to just end, so let's head right into the next area here. Oops. There we go. For a moment, just keeping track of the time.
Do you remember when I mentioned that the client's subconsciousness can feed off of your fear? Some especially vulnerable areas can be very sensitive and dangerous.
Okay.
When you place your consciousness in another's subconsciousness, there is a risk of you getting hurt, of the pain and turmoil of the client's subconscious drawing your own mind into its agony. You must be brave in these areas despite the risk. You must stay calm.
No, I don't know if anything here is actually going to hurt me. Since it is just a tutorial.
You can even pick up and walk around with some objects. To do so, interact with it, and then start walking while holding on to it.
There you go. Oh, shoot, deer got its head broken off. Let's turn up that brightness just a tad. Never mind. I regret everything. Is there like a default thing? No, there's not, but I think it was right about there. The fuzz is a little excessive. I'm not gonna lie. There's the food. Sorry I'm being so silent, but I'm just trying to take in if there's anything different. I remember that. The snow part. It's kind of interesting how the world just like changes like that. I don't recall if a lot of those statues actually had their heads broken off or not. Now, maybe I'm wrong. It has been a little while since I did the recording for Nevermind. But I really do not remember the static. If I'm wrong, then, you know, I'm gonna sound like an idiot. But it does kind of add some tension that wasn't there before. Try closing your eyes and focusing on slow breaths for 5 inhales, okay? Ah, I see. Don't particularly know why it's telling me that. I guess the game is thinking that I'm scared. But I did notice that the color at the top left seemed to be changing. As it appeared I was more nervous. Thank you. hands holding up the bridge. Interesting. Oops. Whoa, you can actually fall off that. I actually about did. Oops. What's this up ahead? That noise I just heard actually did make me nervous. What's this? Cupcake. Okay.
When your consciousness is in enough, just as the client's mind, tread lightly.
Okay. Now, I will say that having the sensor definitely makes you feel more of a part of the game, even as simple as the change has been. Again, it's a tutorial, so it's not going to hit me too hard.
At Neurostalgia, we take great measures. However, if the client...
Alright. Might be able to get through this in one video. Oh god, this part. Wait, that's right. Wherever I stand, it doesn't hurt, right? I can't remember. Just take my time. The hell? Oh. That's right. And we try to grab the hand here. That is what happened, right? God, it's so creepy. And then we did it. Simple enough. Grab a little note. Worst birthday ever. And now we take a little swan boat ride. Seems like I'm doing a lot with Hansel and Gretel lately. Between the park and Nevermind, I guess. Okay, they're giving me tips to calm my breathing. Interesting that it's giving you tips on how to calm down, which are actually pretty useful. I think my heart rate might just be a little too high for this game. Or it might not, the device might not be configured properly. Alright. So, just like last time, we have compiled all of the photos. And we have to put together the ones that, fit. Okay. So this one goes right there. There we go. Simple enough.
Oh my god. Oh my god. It's all rushing back to me. so awful, and I don't want to remember, but yes, I now know the face of my demon. My sister and I, we were taken out.
So, the tutorial didn't have much new for us, so that's pretty. But we do have a new client now. Client 251, being seen by Dr. Hillshire. Reports feelings of scopophobia. I'll have to look that up. I don't quite remember what scopophobia is. That have heightened since her mother's death. Has no conscious recollection of any traumatic events happening in the past. Percentage of imprint explored, 0%. So, still got time, right? Let me see real quick. Oh yeah, we got like 10 minutes. I can start it up. So, scopophobia, huh? Since her mother's death. It seems there's only one more after this, but I have a feeling the other ones are going to be a bit longer than that tutorial. If not, I might be very disappointed.
I guess I don't know where to start. Anywhere? Okay. Well, I've been a real estate agent for the past 20 years. I graduated from a small college, just about half an hour from here, actually. I've never been married. I have no siblings. I've always loved cats. I hate churches. I guess I've always been a little bit of a loner. I really hate how people look at me. Especially lately. I've honestly felt pretty, I don't know, normal. Until about a couple of years ago, after my mother's death. That was when things started to come apart. Do you ever feel like people are just staring at you? Like when you walk into a room and everyone knows something they're not telling you? I don't know, I just feel awful when I'm around people. Guilty, angry at... I had a pretty happy childhood. My dad passed away when I was just a kid. My mother told me that he died in a car accident. I don't remember that day, though. Maybe I was too young. My dad and I always played jigsaw puzzles together. He was a businessman. I remember him always talking about the family finances. My mom and I were never all that close, but I do miss her. She loved her wine. Lord, I don't know why this is happening to me. I was the perfect little girl.
Well, that was, pretty sad story. While that was ongoing, I kind of muted myself and looked up scopophobia. As she described there, scopophobia is pretty much, the fear of being looked at or seen by others. Also usually linked with the fear of drawing attention to oneself, which makes sense. Me having a tea party. It was so hot that day. I remember being so thirsty. And she's talking about being thirsty. There was a tea party right back there. Alright. You're like a music box over here for some reason. Weird. Hey, there's a note up here. Or something in the mailbox. Can I look at it? Past due. Bills, perhaps? thermostat. I know I'm a little shorter than I would expect to be.
I did my best.
Oops.
Why can't you pay the bills?
I'm trying.
It's your fault.
You pay them then.
Right. I don't like the doors closing. That kind of creeps me out. So yeah, definitely something to do with not being able to pay the bills. For only the happiest of families. Okay. Alright. Gordon Merriweather, Santa Claus is coming. Man, they really like their puzzles, huh? Managing stress. That's funny. Living with cancer. I'm alright. You're alright. Now, they said that your psyche was going to link with the psyche of your patient. And the titles of these books seem to be more about our character than about maybe the person that he's studying. He or she, depending on who's playing the game, I suppose. Puzzles, I assume. Yeah, the happiest girl in the world puzzle. Impress your parents. Yeah, not so subtly saying that maybe this family wasn't so great. They have a lot of pictures. Hello?
I'm in the shower. Go ask your father.
About what?
Go ask your father, honey. Go ask your father, honey. I'm in the shower, sweetheart. Go ask your father. Go ask your father.
Okay. Father? Oh, father. The music's nice. Modern casseroles and more. Recipes that you can leave alone. Oh, I get it. Because you don't have to, like, stay dedicated to a casserole. Pay bills, take a shower, pour a drink, tips for dinners when you have other things going on. Okay. That's probably not a hint about anything. That's probably just a book. Okay. This room was not a huge deal. Why won't this door open? You want to run that by me again? Okay.
Turn the lights off and go to sleep, honey.
What? What? That wig thing up there is really creepy. What's this? Gun permit. Printed name of holder is Daddy. Great. So, basically, her dad had a gun. Talking to your child about cancer. Oh. Okay. See the dark. You must kill the light. Yeah, he more or less told me to turn the lights off. Living with cancer. So maybe these are books specific to the family. Maybe they aren't hinting about us in particular, but managing stress seems like... I guess this family was also having troubles with stress too, though. That's not fair. I know what I'm supposed to do here, but I'm trying to figure out how to do it. Is there a switch here? Okay. What? Well. Alright. Cool. The Solutions. Volume 2. That which lies before you can be realized through that which has been left behind you. Well, sadly, I think we are fresh out of time. Yes, we are. Alright. Well, I'm interested in this. I'm curious to see where it goes, and good god, that picture on the right back there is creeping me out. Let's get a quick close look at that before, Oh. Lovely. Alright. Well. If you... excuse me. If you guys enjoyed this video, I know half of it was old stuff, and only barely some new. But, if you guys liked this video, please leave a like and subscribe, and I hope to see you all in the next video. See you then.